This is the Simple Task Tracker Spreadsheet demo. In this demo, I'm going to show you how to set up your template as well as how the template works. The first tab is the Instructions tab. Here you'll find my contact information and a step-by-step guide that walks you through how to set up your template. The next tab is the Setup tab. The Setup tab is pretty simple. It has three columns, the first column being the category column, the next the priority, and the status. It comes pre-filled with these categories, but you're welcome to delete them all and add your own specific categories. The same applies for the priority and the status. The only difference is that when you are editing the priority, try not to delete or alter these two cells that are grayed out. Some of the formulas reference them in order to work properly. The last column is the status option, and here you can delete all of the options here and type in what works for you. All right, so moving on to the task tracker. The task tracker has two main areas. The first area is this top part that comes with different graphs and tables that can help you visualize the information in the table. And the second area here is the table, which is where you input all of your tasks. So we'll start by going over the sections and then we'll put in some tasks so you can see how it works. In this cell, we have today's date. You don't have to do anything to make this work. It works automatically. Here we have two options to filter. When we have some examples, I will show you how that works. Here we have an example of a graph that displays the task by categories, the other one that displays the task by priority, and the last one that displays the task by status. We have a table that will display your top five high priority tasks. That way you can quickly glance over here and see the tasks that you need to pay attention to. Anywhere you see this icon that looks like a rectangle, it means that you can filter the data in the table area. To add a task, all you need to do is click into the cell, type in what you need to type in. When it comes to the drop-down arrows, just click on the arrow and select the option that you want. If the option that you're looking for is not here, you can always go back to the Setup tab and make any changes to the categories. Then type in your task here. Double-click to select a due date or a start date. This is when you intend on working on the task. And the end date or due date is the day that you intend on completing the task. So I'll go ahead and select the 24th. That way you see that we have 5 days to complete this task. The duration is the difference between the start date and the end date. And the days left is the difference between today's date and the end date. These two dates calculate automatically. For the priority, status, and dates completed, all you need to do is select the option that works and select the dates that you have completed the task. And finally, you can add any notes that you need related to that specific task. Now that I've added a few more tasks, you can see that the task category now displays the categories that we have added. The high priority tasks are displayed here, and you can see the task priority and the task status breakdown graphs. All right, so let me show you how these filters work. This first filter is used to display your task priority. So let's select the first option, which is the high, and it shows you that we have two high priority tasks here. It also highlights the two high priority tasks in the task area. The second filter allows you to filter by the due date. So if I wanted to see any of the tasks that were overdue, for example, I would select that and you can see that I have 5 tasks that are overdue. Looking down here, you see that we have the green that represent the tasks that are overdue. And we also have this orange color, which is not represented here. And this is because these two tasks are both high priority and overdue. So if I were to change this date to something in the future, you see that it changes to back to yellow because it's high priority, but it's no longer overdue. Basically, we have 3 different colors. The first color represents the priority, which is yellow. The green color represents the status, and this orange color that displays tasks that meets both criteria. The last thing I want to show you is how to use these checkboxes. It can be used in 2 ways. So let's say these 2 tasks have been completed. All I need to do is to check the box and it crosses them off the list. It also removes them from the display area so that the only tasks that are displayed here are the tasks that have not been completed. Other way to use this checkbox is to use the filter option. After you've checked up these 2 boxes, let's say you only want to see in the table the task that you have not worked on. All you need to do is to click on this icon that has the check next to it. We do want to display the tasks that have not been completed, meaning that they don't have a checkbox. So check off this true, so only false is displayed, and hit OK. And once you filter it this way, you can see that only the tasks that you need to currently work on are displayed. That way, you can keep track of all of your tasks, including the ones that are completed, without having to delete them. Similarly, the other filters work the same way. So you have a filter that you can view tasks by category, days left, by priority, and by task status. All right, so that is the end of this instruction guide. If you have any questions, like I said before, my contact information is available here. And you can also reference the step-by-step guide if you need more information. If there is something about this template that you would like to change, use the contact information here to send me a message. Thank you so much for watching.